Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to America's Motor City, Detroit, Michigan. We're here at the North American International Auto Show for 2014. It's the press preview, and Doug Damon is my name, and it's nice to have all of you. If you've ever been to an international auto show here in Detroit, this would be the year for you to come. Perseverance, resilience, reinvention of the automobile industry, that's what we're going to see here over these million square feet of Cobo Center. And we're glad and honored to have you. And in conjunction with the community television network in your area, we're going to take you through the complete million square feet. So sit back, relax as we do all the work for you. Now, the auto show just isn't about automobiles, it's about the people. And most importantly, ladies and gentlemen, it's about the economic infusion that we get here in Detroit. Roughly about $350 million of revenue will be brought in through this event. And it also includes about 780,000 people will attend the public show. They get a chance to meet some of the people that helped design these cars, and they get a chance to ask questions. You, the customer, that's what this is all about. We couldn't do it without the staff that we have come down and the volunteers, and we have one such person, young person that happened to, she likes automobiles, she likes violins. Her name's Carmen Flesher. She happened to see the program, volunteer to come down. Carmen, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Now, Carmen, I've noticed you have a violin. It's a little different kind of machine, I guess. Tell us a little bit about yourself. You like automobiles. Saw the program. You wanted to come on down.
Yeah, so I'm a student at the University of Michigan. I'm doing music and science, so I'm trying to find a way to combine the two. I've been playing violin for 15 years, so most of my life. And so it's a very important part of who I am. And yes, I do like cars, and it's a big part of my family. My grandpa worked for Ford for 40 years, and my uncle works for Ford currently, so.
Fantastic. So you found a real interest in automobiles and your music. And I'm sure a lot of us who drive cars love that quiet moment in our car. We have a nice stereo. We have some great classical music. You're going to get a chance to give us a little bit of that romance with your violin. So we're certainly glad that you came on down.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, stay with us here at the North American International Auto Show for 2014, the press preview. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for staying with us here at the press preview, North American International Auto Show. It's America's Motor City. And not besides automobiles that come from the local area, we also have them coming, they're coming all the way from Germany. One of the most favorite areas that we like to stop at is Mercedes-Benz. We have Paul LaPinta with us. He's going to give us some good insight as to the history of the company and also about this gorgeous convertible, because a lot of us in Michigan just love to drive convertibles in the spring and summer. Paul, thanks for taking the time.
Thank you for having me here.
Good. Paul, tell us a little bit about this gorgeous convertible.
Sure. So behind us we have our 2014 SL550 Roadster, and it's actually the SL, obviously, is one of Mercedes' iconic products, just like the S-Classes in sedans and luxury vehicles. In sports cars, it's the legendary SL. And when it all started with the SL in the 1950s with the legendary 300 SL Gullwing, and Mercedes has been known for that for a long time, but the Gullwing had some really incredible construction with the space frame design at that time. It actually, the new SL carries that tradition forward, and we have a lot of aluminum construction. The entire body is actually made out of aluminum. And of course, aluminum is one of the strongest materials, but it also is lightweight. So with this generation SL, we've actually shaved off several hundred pounds, which of course means better fuel efficiency and better handling.
Does this car come in diesel, or is it regular fuel?
For the SL Roadster, it's only gasoline
Okay, very good. And fuel efficiency obviously is a big, big idea on people's minds. And you're saying this car is all aluminum.
Yes, that's right. So the whole car is aluminum, and of course that makes it a lightweight construction, so it's more efficient than its predecessor.
Now, Mercedes-Benz has always been involved in the North American International Auto Show. And when did the company get started?
The company got started in it started in 1896 with Carl Benz and his patent Motorwagen, the three-wheel Motorwagen, when he invented the horseless carriage, basically. And it continued. Gottlieb Daimler also was developing vehicles separately. And then in 1926, the two companies merged to form Daimler-Benz, and of course, the legendary Mercedes-Benz that we know now today. So we actually have celebrated a few years ago over 125 years of history.
That's fabulous. And it just started with one guy with an idea, a horseless carriage. We had somebody in our local area almost simultaneously doing the same thing. And now all this merges right here at the North American International Auto Show.
Mm-hmm. Yes, here we are today.
Paul, thanks you. This Mercedes has got some great products, folks. And thanks for staying with us. And we'll be back to you. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back here at the Press Preview, the Detroit International Auto Show. We're here at one of our favorite places for those of us that grew up in Detroit. It's Cadillac. When you think of that name, right away you think of luxury, you think of design. There's a lot of things that just fill the heart. We have Bob Boniface with us. He's one of the designers. Bob, thanks for taking the time out.
Nice to be here.
Good. Bob, tell us a little bit about what's new with Cadillac, and we've heard so many good things about this brand.
Well, you know, for people who, some people have a wrong notion of Cadillac. They think of Cadillacs from the 1970s or the 1960s. They think of luxury by the pound, these very large cars that were soft handling, quiet ride, but not much of a driver's car. Cadillac today is on a different mission. These are driver's vehicles now. They're lightweight, they're agile, they're powerful. This new CTS, by the way, back here, is the lightest car in its class. It's got aluminum doors, aluminum hood. This one's the V-Sport with 420 horsepower. But for me, the designer, it's all about how the car looks. And so you'll notice the car is what we call lower, longer, leaner. The car is lower than before. It's thinner than before. The lines are beautifully taut and stretched. It's a very elegant car. So that's what Cadillac's about now. Elegance, driver satisfaction, performance.
Indeed. And as we've seen them out in the freeways and stuff, your eye definitely is aesthetically pleased by the lines. And I guess designers have to be inspired by things. What are some of the things that help inspire you in your design process?
Well, you know, you're inspired by a lot of things. But for me, vintage automobiles are a big part of what I do, my passion. Cars that were designed before excessive regulations, cars that had long hoods and the cab was slid rearward and the wheels were out and the glass was in. We try to get that into our cars today, and that's what you see on this car. It's the proportions are beautiful. The fenders are very thin. The short front overhang is very short. But you talk about the what we call the down-the-road graphic. You see a Cadillac from far away. That's a lot of things. What we call the light guide, these vertical light blades. You notice, you can tell day or night if the car is a Cadillac.
Indeed, indeed. And one of the favorite things about Cadillacs is the luxury on the inside. As you're in traffic jams, you've got time to be by yourself and listen to some nice music that might be inside.
What we're talking about Cadillac is art and science, not just about the way the car looks, but the technology, the artistry of how the interior is crafted, how the exterior is crafted, but the technology that the car has. We've got Cadillac user interface, all of your Bluetooth syncing, Pandora. You can get all these things on your user interface, so when you're stuck in traffic, you can keep yourself entertained, keep yourself alert and awake. And of course, you're ensconced in cut and sew leather and real wood, real aluminum, real carbon fiber. Honesty of materials is very important to us.
Well, it sounds good, and I can just feel it right now as you described it, Bob. Bob, keep up the good work.
Thanks.
And let's hear a little bit from our violinist to help inspire some of you designers out there. Folks, we're here at the press preview here at the North American International Auto Show, Detroit, Michigan. We're at the Tesla Motor Car Company exhibit. And for a lot of motor enthusiasts out there, we've been tracking this company over the last several years, and it's really come out with some great reinvention of the automobile. And we have with us today Alexis from the company. She's going to give us a little insight about Tesla Motors. Thank you for taking the time.
Pleasure to meet you. Thanks for coming down.
Sure. And now, this automobile is front and center this past year. Everyone's been talking about the power design of this automobile. Give us a little insight about how this car is going to be innovative in the future.
Yeah, so this is Model S that we're in front of. It's the first premium sedan built from the ground up to be electric. It does 265 miles on a single charge, and it is all electric. So you plug it in at home, you wake up the next day with, you know, 265 miles to go.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Now, it's all electric, and you just plug it right in any standard outlet?
We actually encourage our owners to install a 240 outlet in their garage, so standard washer dryer, and what that'll do is charge the car in about 4 to 8 hours.
Wow. We know in some of our communities here in southeastern Michigan, we're starting to see these plug-in areas for parking.
Right. So Model S does charge off of those universal public charging stations. What we've also begun to roll out, though, in the past about year and a half, is the Tesla Supercharger. And that is an in-house product that charges these cars at 120 kilowatts of power. So it's the world's fastest charging technology. And that has the ability to put half a charge on Model S in just 20 minutes.
And the life cycle of these batteries, how long are they projected to last for before replacement?
We really don't see any degradation. We've done long tests on these, and they hold up very well, but they are also warranted for 8 years.
Wow. This is really reducing the carbon footprint. This is giving people a quiet ride, I presume?
Yeah, a quiet ride, an extremely extremely well-toned ride. It has incredible performance. 416 horsepower in this car does 0 to 60 in 4.2 seconds, so just the performance is unbelievable.
And this is American made?
Yes, it is. They're made in Fremont, California.
Fantastic. And it's nice to have you guys come all the way from California to show this car.
Yeah,
and we look forward to seeing this car, Alexis,
pleasure,
out there on the road.
Yeah.
Good. Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen, here at the North American International Auto Show. We'll be right back. ladies and gentlemen, we're here at the Press Preview North American International Auto Show, America's Motor City, here in Detroit, Michigan. We're here at the Lincoln Motor Car Company. And for a lot of us old-timers have been driving since we were little kids, the Lincoln name really has a great history to it. We've got Kevin Kaur from the company to give us a little insight about what's new. Kevin, thank you, sir, for taking the time out.
Thanks for being here with us on the stand.
Indeed, sir. Kevin, tell us a little bit about the excitement about the Lincoln Motor Car Company, some of the new products that we're seeing out there on the road. They're looking great.
Thank you. We're very proud of where we're at in the transformation of the brand. The company decided a few years ago during the crisis, financial crisis, and late in the 2000s to really make Lincoln our bet in the premium industry. And we're well on our way of transforming the brand. We're launching four new products in 4 years. We launched the MKZ medium premium sedan last year. Did great. Sales were up 15% in 2013, and we're real proud of the way this car has been received in the marketplace. And then we're also here at the show showing our brand new Lincoln MKC, and that's a small premium utility. It's the hottest segment in the premium industry. There'll be 8 launches competitively in the segment, and we're really proud to launch the new MKC this summer.
Wow. And that's a utility. So is it a utility vehicle? Is it a standard type vehicle of that nature we might see like a recreational vehicle?
Yeah, it's a small utility. So all-wheel drive as well as two-wheel drive. It competes against competitors like the Audi Q5, the BMW X1 and X3. A lot of the manufacturers are now getting in to these segments as the industry goes smaller, and we're really happy to be launching the right car in the right segment at the right time.
That all-wheel drive, Kevin, is very, very nice. I happen to have one myself. I've noticed how it's excellent on vehicle stability, especially in the kind of weather we get in Michigan.
That's right. It's an important offering, especially for Lincoln, as we try to be relevant to as many people as we can across the country. Most of our vehicles in the Northeast come equipped with all-wheel drive, and clearly between the powertrain offerings of the 2-liter EcoBoost and the new 2.3-liter EcoBoost, which is exclusive to Lincoln, we think those engines combined with all-wheel drive will really offer up a real nice package for our consumers.
And of course, they're safe too, and you've got a lot of nice safety features with these brands.
We do. Lincoln is very competitive in safety. Obviously, I think the biggest thing for us is quality. Every premium brand builds a great vehicle that's safe and reliable, and we're very proud of our heritage of quality and safety with Lincoln, and we're looking to build on that as we go through the next decade and launch all of our new products.
The good thing, Kevin, is to see such excitement here when we come to the display. There's a lot of people here taking interest.
There is. Detroit is really the epicenter of the automotive industry. We were talking earlier, every key manufacturer and all the key industry leaders come to Detroit in January to show what their makes have, and well as learn about what's happening in the industry with the competition. So it's a can't miss week here in Detroit.
Sure is, Kevin, and we hope all our people will be down to see it. We appreciate your time.
Great, thanks so much, and don't forget the Lincoln Motor Company when you're in search of your next premium vehicle. Thanks.
Thank you. Thanks for staying with us, ladies and gentlemen, at the North American International Auto Show Press Preview. We're here at a very exciting company called Fiat. For a lot of folks in the area of Ann Arbor are real familiar with this car. They just opened up a new dealership on Jackson Road. And for it being so small, it's amazing how much room's in here. And we have one of the engineers that designed this car. And this is all electric. We have Brett with us today.
Yes. Nice meeting you.
Thanks, Brett, for taking the time out.
Of course.
As I said, there's a lot of excitement about Fiat these days.
Yes.
And as we see these cars go down the road, sure, they're small but sleek. And if you get a chance to sit in one of these, you almost have to pull the seat up. It's almost too much room. How do you do it?
Well, honestly, the front seat is a full vehicle package. I have a 6'3" son. He and I get in this car, no problem. Wow. We actually do pull the seat up so that you can reach the pedals on it.
It feels like you're in a full-size car when you sit in this. Mm-hmm. Also, it has really nice features as far as the design of the interior. And then this car doesn't use any gasoline. To explain to our viewers, what have you done to make this car so fuel efficient?
Well, of course, this is a completely electric car. So it burns electrons and not calories of gasoline energy. If this were a gasoline car, it is so efficient, it would get 116 miles per gallon.
Wow. It is so light, but yet it's made of steel.
It's made of steel. It's actually got a 600-pound battery in it. But with that battery and the efficient powertrain, it's actually very, very efficient.
Wow, 100 some miles to the gallon, if it would have been fuel efficient in that regard. What type battery is it?
Well, it's lithium ion battery. As we said, it's 600 pounds. It's bolted to the underneath of the floor. And because of that, it stiffens the body up and makes it a much more fun car to drive.
Ah, helps with weight factor and distribution and so forth.
Absolutely.
Good. And quietness, too. I was quite surprised how quiet these cars are.
Yeah, exactly. It's 20% quieter than the regular car. A lot of that is powertrain noise being taken out, but we put about 12 different quality enhancement packages in it, including an acoustic windshield, so you do not hear the air when you drive down the road.
The quality is amazing in Fiat, these little cars, and we're seeing these dealerships spring up all over. And it's made, where is this car made?
The car is made in Toluca, Mexico, right on the same assembly line as the regular gas car. So we go a BART and a couple of gas, and oh, there's an electric one getting put together. So
that's great. Our south of the border, we've got people out there making good quality products for our market up here. And also the stereo system I found was quite unique. Very pleasant to listen to. You feel like you're in a concert when you're driving this car.
Yeah, it's got the Alpine Premium audio system, and I think it does a pretty good job. It's a little car, so you don't have much to do, but it does sound pretty nice.
It sounds like you're in a recording studio when you're driving around in this car. It's fun car, Brett. Keep up the good work over at Fiat.
Thank you very much.
Good. Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. Folks, we're here at the Ford F-150 truck display here at the North American International Auto Show Press Preview. And for many of us, this is one of our favorite stops. When you do come on down to the show, make sure you come on over to this section. A lot of our viewers are in love with this truck because it's helped create employment for them. They found a way to make this machine work for them. We've got somebody from Ford Motor Company that's an expert on this, Mr. Doug Scott. Nice to have you here, sir.
Doug, nice to see you.
Indeed.
Happy New Year.
Thank you. You too. And I see it's been a good year for Ford Motor Company, and in particular, this product.
Well, fabulous year. We ended up selling over 760,000 F-Series in 2013. That was up 18% over 2012, was our highest volume since 2006, our best market share since 2000. We got almost 40% share of the full-size pickup business, and our biggest leadership margin over our nearest competitor, over 282,000 units.
Wow. And as I said, people are using this vehicle to actually produce income for themselves. And my neighbor, in fact, is one of them. I happen to watch him every day out there. He gets up early. He's got all kinds of things in that truck when he comes home. He had lost his job about 2 years ago and has found a way to go out and cut trees, rip things apart, or build things with this vehicle.
Well, you know, Doug, with our customer, whether you're talking about our vocational customer, like you're describing your neighbor, or the recreational customer, it's all about productivity because they look at the truck as a tool. So how can the truck enable them to do more in less time for less money? And even, again, the recreational customer, a little different slant in that we all have very scarce free time, and we usually want to maximize that free time pursuing whatever our passion is. So, you know, you get the hunter, the fisherman, they're interested in how quickly can I get that trailer hooked up and get the boat to the lake and get it unloaded and spend as much time on the water as possible. So it's about making that tool more productive. That's the mentality that we have. And, you know, with this new 2015 F-150, we're delivering that new standard in full-size pickups that really is going to take productivity to a whole new level.
And also the F-250 is going well, too. It's a comfortable vehicle if you happen to drive that vehicle, and a lot of people are telling me how enjoyable it is to drive that vehicle. They can relax. It's quiet on the inside.
Sure. Well, the Super Duty is all about towing. We call it the ultimate towing machine, and that's capability really to the maximum, and from both towing and a payload standpoint, and a very strong product. The 6.7 liter diesel is a fantastic powertrain, 400 horsepower, 800 foot-pounds of torque. You know, can tow your house practically. So it's been a great year for F-Series, but we're not standing pat. That's what's, you know, really cool about this new truck is that people are saying, oh, you're doing so well. Why all of a sudden are you introducing something new? You know, do you really need it? And the point is, we're always about continuous improvement, trying to give the customer more, and that's what we're doing here with this new truck.
Well, things don't stand still, Ford Motor Company, that's for sure.
No, absolutely not. No.
And it's nice having you, Doug, stop by. We know you're busy out there, and continue with the good work. Stay with us here, ladies and gentlemen, at the North American International Auto Show for 2014.
Cool. Thank you, Doug.
Thanks for staying with us, ladies and gentlemen, here at the North American International Auto Show. It's 2014, and we couldn't do these programs if it wasn't for good volunteers out in the community. People see the program and they realize, hey, we're just all coming down to have fun. I'd like to give that a try. But we have people, too, who have spent a lot of time and effort in learning pieces of this business as far as digital media. In fact, one of the volunteers that are with us today is Shannon Kolitz, just a nice young lady. Shannon, thanks for taking the time out.
My pleasure.
Now, you saw our program and said, hey, Doug, there's any way I can get involved. You put your hand up and here you are.
Yeah, here I am shooting video.
And have you ever been to anything like this before?
No, I've never been to the auto show before, which I should have been, being a Michigan native, so I feel like this is a rite of passage that I should come here.
Exactly. And now you graduated from the University of Michigan in Ann Arbor.
Correct. In 2011.
Wow, time goes fast, doesn't it?
It does, yes.
And now you have your own business.
That's correct. It's called Media Academica, a video and animation production company located in Ann Arbor.
Fantastic. And I happened to see some of your work. I was real impressed. So I was quite honored that you offered to come on down and help out. And now that you're in your own business, now you feel in control.
Yeah, I do everything, storyboarding, shooting, editing. So a lot of control.
Well, folks, if you're out there, you need something shot, you need something edited, you always can get a hold of Shannon Kolitz. And how can they get a hold of you?
You can email me at shannon.kohlitz, K-O-H-L-I-T-Z, at mediaacademica.com. or Google Media Academica, which I can spell for you. It's MediaAcademica.
Great, Shannon. And I know you do good work. I've seen it. And thanks for helping support our program and those out there who are viewers as well. Stay with us here at the North American International Auto Show. Thanks, Shannon.
Thank you.
Last but not least, as we interview some of the volunteers who've come down, we have Mr. Albert Speyer III. He's been doing a lot of the behind-the-scenes work. He's been a great editor for this program over the years. Volunteer who's now turned professional. Al, we've always appreciated your good work over these years.
Yeah, thank you, Doug. It's been a real joy and pleasure to come down every year and see the new changes and innovation of the vehicles.
I think you and I both grew together throughout this process, and you in particular have really refined your skills in this area of videography, digital media. It's growing out there, and a lot of young people like yourself have found a way of supplementing income, if not developing a business around this.
Oh yeah, definitely. It's a fun hobby to turn into a professional business. I tried at it, and it just seems you have to have a lot of advertisement, and that's a lot of money.
There you go. And but by getting off the couch, coming on down, you advertise yourself. And anytime you say anything, you're in front of the public, this is what we do. And here in Detroit, I don't think they do it any better than here at the North American International Auto Show, and you've been a big part of that, Al. God bless you. And stay with us, folks, here at the Press Preview. Well, here we are, ladies and gentlemen, concluding the Press Preview, the North American International Auto Show for 2014 here in America's Motor City, Detroit, Michigan. We hope you've enjoyed this broadcast. We've had a chance to get kind of up close and personal with some of the people that helped design these automobiles. And we also felt the resurgence in the perseverance of the people from this industry helped move it forward. We can definitely see that the industry is reinventing itself right here in Detroit, Michigan. We covered about 1 million square feet, Carmen, so hopefully your feet aren't killing you and your fingers are still doing well. Her music has just been inspiring everybody as we've gone around. Tell me, Carmen, as you've had a chance to see your first auto show, what was your impression?
It was very glamorous, very exciting, lots going on, lots of people, lots of different cars and technology, so it's very, very exciting to be here.
Well, good, and it's definitely an international event. We're meeting people from all around the world, and you've had a chance to make them feel comfortable with some of your compositions.
Yeah, hopefully. Music was a way of connecting all sorts of people, so.
What was one of your favorite cars here?
Oh, I don't know if I had a favorite. I like the fancy cars that nobody can afford. They're kind of fun to look at, so.
Sure, who knows, someday you keep that up in that violin, we might be in here hearing you around the world and seeing you driving one of those cars. Well, thanks so much, and you're going to get a chance to play a little something for us. What is it?
This is a snippet from Vivaldi's Four Seasons of Spring.
Fantastic. Thank you.